If you think your bass is too heavy and you're looking for a better and more lightweight version, you might want to watch this video. Let's get started. This is Gregor from bassdebo.com, and in this video we're checking the new California SL bass from Sandberg Guitars, this one here. SL stands for super light, and this description is actually appropriate because this one weighs only 3 kilos here, which is nothing. So let's check it out. Before we can dive deeper in this topic, I have to give you once again a short disclaimer because I'm personally affiliated with Sandberg Guitars. I'm the Sandberg Guitars artist relations manager for most countries in the world, and I'm also the guy who's answering all the emails that Holger, the Sandberg founder, doesn't want to answer himself. That means I'm a little bit biased here, but it of course also means that I know a thing or two about Sandberg basses. Keeping that in mind, let's check the California SL. The main reason of course why this bass is so lightweight is because of the woods. For the body, Sandberg is using cedar. This is obviously a softer and much more lightweight option than the ash and alder bodies Sandberg is usually using for the California basses without exotic wood tops. The neckwood has also changed. Instead of the Canadian hard rock maple Sandberg is using for all their necks, the SLs come with a so-called Norway maple. It doesn't actually come from Norway, it's right here from Germany, and according to Christian, the Sandberg workshop overseeing type of responsible person, it's surprisingly a lot lighter than the hard maple. Right now the California SL is available in a TT and in a TM pickup configuration, but of course if you're a VS or a VM guy you can order that too. And right here I have the very first California SL TT. It's equipped with Sandberg Black Label pickups. They look and pretty much sound like single coils, but they're hum cancelling humbuckers with ceramic magnets. The preamp is of course still the standard Sandberg 2-band EQ. It's custom made by Glockenklang here in Germany and allows to actively control basses and highs. When you pull the master volume, it switches the bass to passive mode and then you have a regular tone control instead of the active highs. The second control lets you choose between the pickups and mix them to your liking. Hardware is the standard Sandberg aluminium bridge and tuners, which are already very lightweight. In fact, the tuners are the lightest tuner you can get on the market right now. They are even lighter than Hipshot Ultralights. That all sounds good on paper, but what does it actually mean for the bass? What does it mean to the sound? And how does the SL, of course, compare to regular Sandberg basses? I would say the first impression that you will definitely get when you're playing one of those, and this is the main thing, it's very, and I mean it's very, very punchy. In In comparison, it might lack a little bit of low end, but this is something you can easily adjust with your amp. I think there's no need to hide that this bass is definitely a compromise. The demand for lightweight basses is huge, and if you don't get why, let's talk again in 20 years or 30, depending on your age. You can't expect a 3 kilo bass to sound exactly like one that is a third heavier. That would be naive, but at the end what only counts is it usable and does it sound good, and that I can confirm. A couple of months ago I met Stuart Sander, the original Jamiroquai bassist, and we spent 2 days in the studio to record some fun stuff, and Holger was the Sandberg founder, was also there, and he brought the first prototype, which was a California SLTM, so we had a humbucker on the bridge and a single coil in the neck position, and yeah, we gave this bass to Stuart and recorded with it, and it sounded great and we had a lot of fun. Actually, Stuart took this bass home with him afterwards, and a couple of weeks later I wrote him and asked him what he thinks of the bass, and he answered, let me read. Hi Gregor, yes indeed I have, it's my new best friend. Light, versatile and easy functioning. I've played some shows with it already, it's an awesome bass and I love it, thank you. I mean, if it's good enough for Stuart Sander, well, this doesn't actually have to mean anything to you, but let's just hold on to the fact that he's the craziest and the funniest motherfucker on earth right now, which also has nothing to do with this bass but needs to be said at some point. Which is now. That's it for the review. I hope you enjoyed it. Again, very interesting bass, super lightweight, super, super comfortable to play. If your neck hurts or your back hurts or anything hurts and you want to play a lighter bass to get rid of these problems, check the California SL. It's an interesting bass and I guess you will love it. That's it for today. See you next time. Don't hesitate to smash the like button below if you like this video and subscribe to this channel if you want to see more of those. We are releasing bass reviews or any kind of other bass stuff every week. And yeah, it's a lot of fun. Join us. That's it for today. See you next time and have a wonderful life. Thank you.